Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn a new chapter, and the title of the chapter is Adaptation in Plants. The chapter is about animals that live in different regions, okay, and how they survive in that particular region, whether the region is cold or hot, how the animals have special features to survive in that particular place. Okay, so there are some terms that you have to learn that I will tell you at the end of the video. So please learn those terms and words, which is very difficult for you. Okay, now shall we start the chapter? Yes, please take out your worksheet. Adaptation in plants. A natural place where animals live and grow is called its habitat. Animals live in different habitats, such as land, water and air, adjust themselves in their surroundings. So, what do you mean by habitat? Habitat is a place that where the animals grow, they live and grow in that particular place, and that particular place is called habitat. Animals live in different habitats, such as land, water and air, and they adjust according to the place, according to the surroundings. So, what do you mean by habitat? Habitat is a place where the animals grow, live and grow. Okay, so we will learn about adaptation in animals. Adaptation in animals, it is a process in which the animal changes itself to suit to the surroundings or atmosphere is called adaptation. Adaptation is very essential for all living things for their survival. So, all the animals need this particular adaptation, that features to survive in particular region. Now, the adaptation, animals adapt according to three reasons. The reasons are according to the habitat. Habitat is the environment or the place where the animals grow and live. The second thing is food habit, the food that they have in that particular region. Understood. The next is protection. So, for the protection, how the animals live in particular region. So, now we will see in this video, we are going to learn about adaptation to the habitat. And the first one is animals that live on land. We will see. So, we learned that animals, we saw that animals have three different adaptation. One is adaptation to the habitat, the second one is adaptation to food habits, and the third one is adaptation to protection. Now, the first one is animals that live on land are called terrestrial animals. So, first one we are going to learn about adaptation to the habitat, and in that the first one is animals that live on land are called terrestrial animals. What are terrestrial animals? Terrestrial animals are animals that live on land. Okay. Example, you have dog, cat, lion or cow. Now, we will see to the adaptation of these animals that live on land. Adaptation means features. Okay. Features of a particular animal that live on land. They have legs and limbs to move, they breathe through lungs, and they have well developed nervous system and sense organs. I will repeat it again. The adaptation of land animals are, they have legs or limbs to move, they breathe through lungs, well developed nervous system and sense organs. Now, we shall see some examples. Here, dog, cat, cow, giraffe, tiger, all these are terrestrial animals. Terrestrial animals means that live on land. Dog, cat, cow, giraffe, tiger, they all have legs, they have legs to move, and they breathe through lungs. Yes. Now, moving on, the second one is animals living in mountains or polar regions. Example, polar bear, arctic fox, mountain goat and yak. Now, we will see to its adaptation. As I said earlier, adaptation means special features of these animals. Okay. The animals that live on mountain or polar region have heavy fur on their bodies. Why do they have heavy fur on their bodies? They have heavy fur on their bodies. Fur means hair. Okay, the hair, just like the hair that we have in our body. They have fur. The hair on the animals are called fur. They have heavy fur on their bodies. They have thick skin to bear cold and a layer of fat under their skin which protect them from cold climate. Okay, so these three help them to survive in the cold climate. The mountain goat has small hooves that help to climb up and down at steepy rocky mountains. Okay, so mountain goats have hooves. Hooves means their feet is having a hard object, body object, and it helps them to climb up and down on steepy rocky mountains. The mountains are very hard, isn't it? So the mountains are very hard, so it helps the hooves. Hard hooves help them to climb up and down. Now the examples are polar bear, mountain goat, yak and Arctic fox. If you look very carefully, this polar bear has all these animals have heavy fur on their body. If you look for polar bear, there's yak, there's Arctic fox, and these all animals have heavy fur so that they are protected from the climate. When you look in this picture, the mountain goat has hooves and long horns which help them to climb the mountains. Okay. Now when you look in this picture, Arctic fox, it is a kind of fox that live in polar region and it has fur, okay, which protects them from the cold climate. Now moving on, now the third one is animal living in desert. Now in the previous one we learnt that is living in cold climate. Now we will learn about the animals that live in hot climate. Okay. Example, camel, desert fox, horned viper, lizard. These are some examples of animals that live in desert. Now the adaptation. As I said earlier, adaptation means special features of these animals. Most of the desert animals are small in size. Okay. So these desert animals are small in size. They can live without food and water for many days. So they have special character. They are adapted to live without food and water for many days. Now, the sheep of the desert, the camel. The camel has padded feet to move on sand and humps on their back to store fat. If you have seen the picture of camel, you will understand that a camel has padded feet. Padded feet means it is having a special kind of padded feet so that it will not sink into the soil in the desert. Okay, it helps them to move on sand. And the specialty of a camel is that it has humps on their back in which they store the fat which help them to survive without food and water for many days. They have long eyelashes that protect their eyes during sandstorm. Sandstorm is a storm which happens in the desert by which the sand is carried away. And during that storm, the animals in the desert area have long eyelashes. These camel and all have long eyelashes that protect their eyes during the sandstorm. Okay. Now moving on. The pictures. See, you can see the picture of a camel. It is drinking water from an oasis. Okay. And this is the picture of lizard, a desert lizard. And it is a fox, desert fox. If you look into this picture, it doesn't have any much fur compared to the Arctic fox in the previous slide. Okay. Because the climate is very hot in desert, so it has to survive. And this is horned viper. It is a snake found in desert area. Now, the next one is aquatic animals. Aquatic animals are animals that live in water. What are aquatic animals? Aquatic animals are animals that live in water. Now we will see into the adaptation. Most of the aquatic animals have gills to breathe. And if you see it, this is the gill. Okay, these cuttings on the right and the eye on both the sides of the fish is called gills, and they breathe through gills. They have fins and tails which help them swim in water. This is called fin. If you look in this picture, this is fin and this is the tail part. Tail part helps the fish to move to the direction, change its direction, and fin help them to stand, I mean to swim properly in the water. Okay, now the third adaptation feature is they have slender shaped body which help them in living under deep water. They have slender means very soft body, it is not very hard, it's very soft body, so that they can live under the water. Okay, now water birds like duck have webbed feet. Why do they have webbed feet? It helps them to swim. If you look in this picture, you can see the webbed feet. It helps them to swim. It helps them to swim very well in water. Now, these are the examples: fish and turtle, and you can see duck, you can see swan in as aquatic animals. All these have webbed feet. I mean, these aquatic animals, some examples of aquatic animals are fish, turtle, swan, duck, everything. And they have very slender body shape. They have slender body shape. Fish have fins and tails, and ducks and other birds like aquatic birds have webbed feet. If you look into this picture, this is a picture of a turtle, and if you look very carefully, you can see the limbs of this animal is padded, and this helps them to swim in water. Okay, it helps them to swim in water. So that's all for that particular portion. Now we will say learn some new words. This is adaptation, habitat, surroundings, survival, protection, polar region, aquatic, slender, amphibians, hibernation, aerial animals, arboreal animals, herbivorous, carnivores, omnivorous, parasites, camouflage, prey. These are some words in your chapter, in the chapter adaptation animals. So please learn the spellings of this particular animals. Go through the worksheet so far that we have learned in this video, and please be prepared for oral test of this particular portion. Okay, so thank you. Please learn very carefully, read the worksheet, and see you in the next class. Thank you.